Hey guys, it's Lynn and Jess, and today we're going to be dyeing this wig, which is Nova's wig, who is a Caroline doll, but we straightened the wig, as you can see.
I know!
How dare we?
Yeah. But we're going to be dyeing it blue, and you're going to see how we do it.
And this is probably going to not work, but let's go! It's like...
Okay, we're going to start by opening up the Sharpies and trying to get the inside out using these dog toenail clippers. Let's see if this works.
Oh.
Oh, you also broke off part of the...
Good thing I bought like 17.
Yeah, true. Is there more in there?
No, I bought like 5 million of this one.
Good, good. Yeah, see, we are loaded.
Yay!
Did you get it? Show it to the camera.
Now we squeeze it in, and we have to open some other ones.
Yeah, squeeze that dye in there. Concluded that we're going to need multiple Sharpies of the same color, so we're going to open the rest of these using the dog toenail clippers, and we'll get back to you after we're done doing that, because I should not touch the camera with my dyed hand.
Yep.
Okay, so we just finished squeezing like 5 Sharpies into here, and it's still not doing much. We're gonna try to do some more research into if there's anything we should be adding into this, because so far all we've done is water and Sharpies. And we tested a little bit on Nova's wig, but didn't really work. So, fingers crossed. What is that noise? Oh, that's Oscar. Hey, nee. So we think we figured out what the problem was. There was the percentage of water to dye was gonna be too high. So we're just gonna dump out some of the water into the garden and see if that helps.
How's that? More?
That looks good. So the first way didn't work, it was too diffuse, I think is the word I want to use.
Yeah.
But what's happening now is that we looked up a tutorial on YouTube, and now we put the dye into that water bottle with a little bit of water and I think some vinegar.
No, it's just water, and then we're gonna shake it 5 minutes, wait 5 minutes, and then put it in this spray bottle, which has a little bit of rubbing alcohol. I think that helps it stick and like brings out the color. So I've just shaken it really well, so now we're gonna let it sit for like 5 minutes and then shake it again.
All right, we'll update you in a few minutes.
Hi.
So now that we've let it sit for a little while and then we shook it again, and now we're pouring it into the spray bottle so we can spray it onto the wig.
We have a little leftover.
Yeah, and the spray bottle already has some alcohol in it.
Do it.
So we're putting the wig down and we're gonna try spraying it with this blue water. It started working a little bit before, so we're really hoping for the best here.
Because it's wet now, so you can't tell whether it's the color that you want.
I think when it dries, it'll be more blue. But we're probably going to have to make some more mix, because we're going to run out.
Yeah, we are.
All right, I'll start cracking open some more Sharpies.
Yeah. And I'll start spraying.
Yeah, look, it's already turning a little bit blue there.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to look like a really pretty teal color once we're done.
This is like... All right, I'll do it, and then you open some Sharpies, and then you'll do it.
All right. Also, note to the viewers, we have a special surprise at the end.
For that.
Yeah. So, be excited for that. Watch this video till the end. Please don't get bored. We might have to do a mashup thing.
This is working so well. You can actually see it better on camera than you can in person, how well it's working. It's so pretty.
It's starting to look really good. I'm excited for Nova.
Let's get this hat.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
So I think the tip we've most kind of found is you have to shake it and you have to add some rubbing alcohol to help the color stay. As you see, it just looks so beautiful.
It's starting to look very blue.
Yes.
When it dries, it'll look a lot more blue, I think.
Yeah, it looks kind of gross right now because it's so wet.
It's very wet.
I'm kind of afraid to like wet her hair after this. This is like sheds color everywhere.
It'll all rub off.
So we also just flipped the wig over. And we're gonna dye the bottom and then flip it back and dye and then add some highlights and some stuff at the bottom. So it should look pretty cool. So we're making our last batch here. So we're just opening the Sharpie. The wig is almost dyed.
Opening the Sharpies is really hard the first time, but after you've done it quite a few times, it becomes really easy.
But you know, still messy. We're going to have a lot of cleanup to do, but oh well. And over there we have our snack.
A little bit in here so it's easier to get the out. This is a very messy job. You're going to have to be prepared to
ruin quite a few pairs of gloves. Maybe a pair of pants.
But so far we've been pretty clean, not to jinx anything.
My fingers are probably permanently dyed blue now.
Same.
Lynn's gonna finish up dyeing that wig blue, and I'm gonna break open some of the darker colored Sharpies to make some highlights.
So we're at it again, and now we're opening the light purple lavender one, and the super dark.
See how easy it is after a few tries?
And yeah, we're gonna mix them, and it's gonna be like the highlight part of the wig, because we want it to be realistic. Look at how dirty her gloves are.
Gosh. I'm gonna have blue fingers for months.
Okay, the dark purple took like 3 seconds to open, and this one's taking like 10 years.
It's just because like the thing's stuck in there. Don't judge me.
Basically, the process that we're doing is break open the Sharpie, squeeze all of it into some water, and we're just using lemon water because I don't have plain water. And then we add it to a spray bottle with alcohol, like some rubbing alcohol. Looks like this. Sorry, you guys can't really see that. But, yeah. It's going pretty well. But
make sure you choose someone that's not you to do this because you don't want to get messy, so make someone else do it.
Oh, I see what I'm here for now. I'm just here to get messy.
What is all over my hand? I don't know if you guys can see this.
Oh, there's, gosh.
There's like white stuff.
What is that? Oh, that's the glove.
Oh, it is the glove.
Yeah, mine has that too.
That's annoying. So yeah, we've ended up wasting like 10 million Sharpies and using 5. That's good.
Yeah, for the first batch we used 5 and then the second batch we're gonna be a little bit.
Oh, that is so pretty. Just add a little bit of the dark, I think.
Okay.
So we're making the highlights, so we're just like taking a piece and putting it over a paper towel so we can spray it without the other pieces getting messed up.
Yes. If you can't see, that is the wig and it is on top of a towel.
It's pretty delicate. This towel.
Starting to turn purple. Look at that. We mixed a few drops of the really dark purple color and most of the light purple, so it's going to be more purple than blue.
And it's not really working yet.
It will.
Probably.
Takes a lot of spraying in case you didn't notice.
A brownish color, but I think once it mixes, able to appreciate the full highlight.
Yeah, be prepared to spend at least like a couple hours doing this. Okay, it's looking a lot better. It's a lot more obvious on camera, the color. It looks so much better on camera than it does in real life. And so day one is over. And we've decided that we dyed the ends a darker color, and we're gonna check on it again tomorrow and see if drying helped it any.
Maybe we'll check on it in a few hours because it might dry a little bit in the next few hours.
Yeah, we're gonna be doing update. It's been about 5 minutes and the hair is already turning bluer, so
it looks so
pretty
good.
Darn awesome.
Hey everyone, so I just glued on Nova's wig and it looks amazing. It came out really great, so yay!
So here's the special surprise. Countdown, 3, 2, 1, reveal.
Ah! I'm so excited. This doll looks exactly like me.
It's really creepy.
She was released in the same year that I was born.
Creepy.
And she has an older brother with the same name as my older brother.
Creepy.
I know. And she looks exactly like me. Exactly.
It's like really creepy.
Same eye color, same like freckles, same flippy hair.
Hair.
Oh my flip. Get it?
I know,
we get it.
So basically my aunt just kind of briefly mentioned she had some dolls upstairs and I was like, what? So I went up to check them out. She had like Kirsten and Samantha, but then she had Lindsay and I was like, oh my goodness, I need to get her because she looks exactly like Jex.
I know.
So I took her home and I'm doing some work for her, for my aunt, but she's just in great condition. She still has the blush. I tightened her limbs and stuff, so she's in really good condition.
She is in very good condition.
She's so cute.
Especially because her hair is so short. That like old dolls, their hair gets in really, really bad condition after a while and it looks bad. But hers is gonna look fine because it's so short though.
We also renamed her because Lindsay, you know, just wanted to rename her. So.
I didn't.
Cameron?
Right, Cameron. It's a reference to a summer series that we were going to make this year but never ended up doing.
Because we didn't have time.
And one of the main characters' names was Cameron, which I really loved, and her nickname is Cammy. And this is this beautiful darling now.
Oh, she's so cute.
I'm so obsessed with her.
She's so cute.
Oh my goodness.